What's up, guys? Wed's here with another Anvil video. Today we have some questions answered by the developers, and we're going to take a look at it and tell you all about it. In any case, they started by saying it's been a week since we launched early access. Here are answers to your most frequently asked questions. Thank you for your interest in our game, and we hope to make this game as fun as possible alongside the players. In any case, there are about 10 questions, but I'm gonna go and answer one of the most popular questions that I have on my channels for the guys on PlayStation. Here it is. Are there plans to support PlayStation? The answer is, our priority is to stabilize the game on Xbox and Steam. Other platforms will be considered when that is in place. So I'm hoping you guys from PlayStation will have the opportunity to play. I don't like exclusivity, so I want you guys to be able to play. In any case, go back to the beginning. It says, how long is the early access period and what sort of contents are planned? And they say, we will respond to emergency issues as fast as we can, and we will have regular updates every month. The addition of new content and major changes will occur every 3 months, which is season. The addition of new weapons, new breakers, and boss monsters plan to be added, and experimental game modes will be revealed for feedback. So we're going to have more stuff coming up. They plan for it. Why are you resetting relics and season upgrades every season? Are you going to wipe our progress after 3 months? This is a very popular question. And then the answer is, the point of the season system is to revamp the game. There will be many new things to do, and many things will change. The numbers and effect that exist will be changed drastically, making need for the upgrade tree to be renewed as well. For new players entering with the new season to fit in, we thought removing long-term growth factor was a good idea. In any case, I'm not going to read the second paragraph, but I'm going to go straight through the third paragraph where they say the last resort. We can't say in detail, but we will try our best to let the players either keep the things they work hard for or at least get reasonable compensation. When we have more things set in stone, we will let the players know through announcement and receive additional feedback to make a final decision. So that's the answer to, as far as we set in this season, every time you got to start over every season. For question number 3, are there plans for cross-invite, cross-save between Xbox and Steam? Will Xbox update be delayed in the future compared to Steam like it is now due to Xbox certification process? As you know, the last update that we have, so we're still waiting for it on Xbox, and that's why we had this question. Now, one thing we know for sure, the update will be coming, but this is their answer. Although we want to avoid emergency patches as much as possible, if a critical issue occurs, we think it is better to respond quickly on Steam first, then wait for Xbox certification and release at the same time. Hopefully that is the case. That way we don't have FOMO. And cross-save is a difficult feature to implement now. However, we think we can prepare transferring data cross-platform soon. Now, for those of you that may not know what cross-save is, cross-save is being able to play on one platform and then you can move to another platform and you don't lose any progress. You don't have to restart. So if that is implemented in the game, it would be awesome. And that way, in this case, for instance, with the guy on Steam having the update first, you could have played on PC and then come back to your console when the update is done, and then you could be good to go. So that would be a good thing. Anyway, for question number 4, they say, any plans for wide monitor support? They say having a wide monitor allows players to see more of the map than other players, which makes it unfair. We are currently discussing this matter, and if there is a good solution, supporting wide monitor isn't a difficult task. So for those of you guys that were asking this, you got your answer. Anyway, question number 5, you say, are there plans to change the number of maximum players for Journey to 3? Are there plans for maps for 4 or above? They say, we decided the maximum number of players depending on the galaxy mode, progression method, and map size. However, there were many players who wanted to just play together with friends, so we will be removing the maximum player restriction of 2 players in Journey for pre-made parties only soon. They say they will do that soon. So basically what they are saying, if you want to play with your friends, you will be able to invite them and then they can play with you more than 2 players. But if you just go to the matchmaking process of the game, then it will be the same. You won't be able to add more than what they set up for the game. Anyway, for question number 6, they say, when will new skins and toy workers be added? They say we already have the skins and toy workers ready. The dev team doesn't want to just increase the number of available options, but make each one unique with different playstyles. With some skin can be added quickly, toy workers will be added after new features are added. This is a secret, but our toy workers will be changed to be way more fun to play with, although we haven't even told our CEO yet. Anyway, for question number 7, it asks, why can you only equip one tier 3 relic? The answer is, equipping a relic is a very entertaining feature, but it can also ruin the balance of the game easily. Although this restricts freedom in using tier 3 relics, this also allows you to think which tier 1 and 2 relics to use. In the classic mode, we will be sticking to this rule for now. They continue to say, Anvil game mode is set up so that changing the rules is not a difficult task. Having a challenge mode where you can equip many relics, for example 6, or having no limit on tier 3 relics can be added, so we ask for your patience. For question number 8, they ask, I keep getting matched in a server that is far away. Are there plans to create servers in other countries or implement a way for us to select servers? Their answer is, we are monitoring the server issues regularly, and if enough people are coming from one region, we can add new servers. Please tell your friends to join you. Anyway, question number 9, there seems to be many people on the ranking using cheating programs. Are there plans to reset rankings? Also, can we see a combined ranking for Xbox and Steam? Currently, we are rooting out cheaters using an anti-cheating tool, and those users will be removed from the rankings. As for ranking reset, we have a fit compensation or reward system in place. We will regularly reset. The combined ranking is a difficult task right now. In the future, when we have tournament modes, it can be implemented, but that is still far in the future. In any case, that was all the question. I already go over number 10. These are all your questions and answers. That's some of the most popular questions. Hopefully, this helps you guys out. Thank you guys for watching. I will see you guys later.